Good morning, dear students. Today we will talk about the endoplasmic reticulum, one of our cell organelles. So what is its location? It is just at the side of the nucleus. You could see this is the nucleus. This is the inner membrane of the nucleus. This is the outer membrane of the nucleus. So in the continuity of this outer membrane of the nucleus, we are having a cellular organelle that is we know as endoplasmic reticulum. You could see now the endoplasmic reticulum is actually a tubular structure where the tubular layers are arranged as stacks. You could see this entire structure is known as endoplasmic reticulum. Now the figure is showing clearly that the tubules appear are of two types. The one is having rough walls, and this is called rough endoplasmic reticulum due to the presence of ribosomes. It is just by the side of the nucleus, nuclear membrane, and outer to it we are having the tubules or tubular structure where the stacks are having a smooth wall. So this is called smooth endoplasmic reticulum. And besides this, we are having vesicles, and the tubular structure are collectively known as cisternae. And besides this, we are having vesicles and certain tubule-like structures, tubules. So all these are the three components of the what? Endoplasmic reticulum. Now we could see that these are the components of endoplasmic reticulum. The first tubular piles or stacks of the tubules is known as cisternae. Second, tubular structure, tubules, and third, vesicles are very smaller, circular, oval entity. So these are the three components of the endoplasmic reticulum. Now this endoplasmic reticulum, when we consider the endoplasmic reticulum, Porter 1961 proposed name, and Garnier 1897 seen and called them as ergastoplasm. So this is the historical account. So whenever we talk about a particular cell organelle, after its introduction, and this is one of the important feature that we should cite its historical account. Historical account means what are the researches which have proved its existence as a particular cell organ. So the main two researchers are the Porter and the Garnier, who have proposed a name and seen this entity and called it as ergastoplasm. Now coming back to the endoplasmic reticulum, now we are aware, or we are very well knowing, that it is made up of three components. So we could categorize the parts of the endoplasmic reticulum as cisternae, vesicles, and tubules. We have seen this cisternae piles or stacks of tubular structures, and then tubules, and then lastly vesicles. Now depending on its structure, this endoplasmic reticulum is of two types. So cisternae is nothing, these are long, flattened, unbranched units arranged in stacks. You could see unbranched, long, flattened units and arranged in stacks. You could see easily. Then vesicles are what? Oval membrane bound structures. And then tubules are irregular, often branched tubes bounded by membrane. This may be free or associated with endoplasmic reticulum. So here all the three components are isolated in the cytoplasm, but these are associated as complex entity in the case of Golgi complex. This endoplasmic reticulum is widespread with GC and is localized in cytoplasm. Now coming back to the structure of the endoplasmic reticulum, it may be either rough. You could see here, this is the type of endoplasmic reticulum, the rough or the smooth. So rough and smooth means ki the rough is having a granular structure, you could see here, and smooth agranular. So what is rough endoplasmic reticulum? This is granular, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum, this is agranular. The rough endoplasmic reticulum is actually due to the presence of ATS ribosomes. You could see here the ribosomes. The rough endoplasmic reticulum have ATS ribosomes bounded on the surface with two glycoproteins, and this is more stable, mainly have cisternae plus vesicles. The RER with ATS ribosomes and mainly have cisternae plus vesicles, while smooth endoplasmic reticulum, this mainly have tubules. So RER is having mostly cisternae plus vesicles, while SES is having tubules. So RER is more stable, mainly have cisternae plus vesicles. This is abundant in cells engaged with protein synthesis as liver, pancreas, goblet cells. So due to the presence of ribosomes, this is engaged with the protein synthesis. Then coming to the SER, this is without ribosomes, and this smooth endoplasmic reticulum is lacking the ribosomes and glycoproteins. This is less stable structure, mainly composed of tubules, and this is abundant. This one is abundant in cells concerned with glycogen and lipid metabolism. Example, adipose tissue, glycogen storing liver cells, and adrenal cortex. Now, this is the component and structure of the endoplasmic reticulum. So, whether we have certain modifications of this endoplasmic reticulum? Yes. The modifications of the endoplasmic reticulum may be sarcoplasmic reticulum, where these are smooth endoplasmic reticulum in skeletal and cardiac muscles and discovered by Virati 1902. This sarcoplasmic reticulum stores calcium ion and energy rich compounds for muscle contraction. The second modification we could have for the endoplasmic reticulum is T-tubules. This is transversely arranged tubules in skeletal and cardiac muscle cells, and this transmits stimulus for contraction of muscles. This transmits stimulus for the contraction of muscles. The third modification of the endoplasmic reticulum is ergatoplasm. This is a small parallel cisternae of endoplasmic reticulum with accumulated ribosomes. The next modification for the endoplasmic reticulum is myeloid bodies. This is a special smooth endoplasmic reticulum in epithelial cells of retina. And the last one we could have, microsomes. This is nothing but pieces of ER. So microsomes is important, because why we are talking about the modification of endoplasmic reticulum? To perform special functions, this endoplasmic reticulum is modified in these following forms, and from any these forms you could have a question like microsomes are. So these are pieces of ER, endoplasmic reticulum with associated ribosomes, and this could isolate them during high speed centrifugation. So you could have a question from the modifications of the endoplasmic reticulum as well, either as filling the blanks or as a multiple choice question. Then what are the enzymes of endoplasmic reticulum? Sucrase, NADH, diphosphate, glucose 6 phosphate, ascorbic acid synthesis, etc. These are the certain enzymes that are linked with the endoplasmic reticulum for its activity. Now we have the knowledge, basic knowledge of the structure and the components of the endoplasmic reticulum. So we should consider their functions as well. The first function for the endoplasmic reticulum is the mechanical support. Mechanical support means with the microfilaments and the microtubules, this forms endoskeleton of the cell and thus gives the mechanical support. And then the second one is the intracellular exchange. Intracellular exchange. For the intracellular exchange, as the intracellular conducting system for the transport of the materials. The third function, we are having the RER, rough endoplasmic reticulum. This rough endoplasmic reticulum is having what? Ribosomes. So this is engaged with the protein synthesis. This RER is engaged with the protein synthesis. Then SER. SER is mainly engaged with the lipid synthesis. And cholesterol and phospholipid are synthesized here. Then the next one is cellular, for the cellular metabolism. ER gives surface area for the cellular metabolism. Then formation of nuclear membrane. The next function we could have for the endoplasmic reticulum is that this is engaged with the formation of nuclear membrane. Fragmented vesicles of the disintegrated nuclear membrane and endoplasmic reticulum forms nuclear membrane around chromosomes during cell division. Then the next one, we are having formation of lysosomes. Formation of lysosomes, Golgi body and microbodies, all these are formed with endoplasmic reticulum. The next function for the endoplasmic reticulum, we could consider the detoxification, where cytochrome P450 in smooth endoplasmic reticulum detoxifies drugs and steroids. This, besides all these aspects, this endoplasmic reticulum provides precursor of secretory material to Golgi body. And the last aspect we could consider, this transport, the transport of the ions, molecules and particles through membrane flows as the route of nuclear membrane to pores, to ER, to Golgi complex, to plasma membrane and then to outside through intramembrane system. Now what is the how this endoplasmic reticulum is synthesized? So the biosynthesis of endoplasmic reticulum, for the biosynthesis of endoplasmic reticulum, Pellardy 1956 suggested that ER originates as an enfolding of the cell membrane or through nuclear membrane by blebbing. What is blebbing? Formation of vesicles or blebs or finger-like projections to form annulate lamellae, double-layered vesicles first, then endoplasmic reticulum after attachment of ribosomes. So this is all about the endoplasmic reticulum, and I think now you are having the basic knowledge of the endoplasmic reticulum. You have revised this in the today class, and where we have discussed the endoplasmic reticulum, its historical account, its structure and its components and its types, as rough endoplasmic reticulum, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Basically RER is linked with the protein synthesis and SER with the lipid biosynthesis, and besides these major two aspects, we are having many modifications for the endoplasmic reticulum. From those modifications, you could have a question in your question paper, and the question you could have in your question paper is that, what is endoplasmic reticulum? Discuss its structure and the function in detail. So you, for that you have to do nothing. You have to introduce your endoplasmic reticulum, and with its figure, well-labeled figure, you could discuss its structure in detail one by one, and depending on its structure, you could discuss its modification at different sites to perform various functions, and its different roles that it plays in the cell. So I have already discussed that in the cell we are having a division of labor. Division of labor, that means the cell is collectively being organized systematically with its different cell components to perform various functions, and this is called the division of labor. So today we have considered the one of the cell organelle, that is endoplasmic reticulum, just by the side of the nucleus, and we have discussed its structure, its modifications and its different functions. Thank you.